Hello guys, today I'm going to demonstrate on how to paint a river with the cliffs, and also it has a cave in it. So first of all, I'm going to introduce to you my materials. I have here my paint palette, and I have a titanium white, a tallow blue, medium yellow, brilliant red, lamp black, and burnt sienna. And I have here my brushes. I have here a 1-inch flat brush. I have number 12 round brush. Number four flat brush. Number 1 flat brush. Number 6 flat brush, and this one is number 0 round pointed brush. I have here my my canvas. I made it myself, and I staple it on a plywood. It's the size is 12 by 16. I have a water on a cap. This is my medium. So first, I'm going to sketch for our landscape painting. So I'm gonna use the burnt sienna, or it is also a brown. Okay. So I'm going to plan for our painting. So I'm going to put here. Going to put here some very big cliff. It's made of a giant stone, and I'm gonna add some cave here, this part. So that might be really fun at all. And also here, I'm going to put another cliff here. This is a huge cliff on a river. And also here. I'm gonna add some really light color in this part. So the scene might be afternoon. I like that. Also another cliff here. I'm gonna add some, I'm gonna have some trees and forest on a cliff, and I'm going to put some big cliff or a big mountain near to our cliff. So okay, so I'm gonna add some distant mountains here. So this must be curious. So I'm not gonna add the sky on this painting. So this time there's no sky on this one. Okay, this one. Okay, so I think we're ready for our first coats or the base color. Okay, so I'm gonna use the flat brush 1-inch. Okay, I'm going to use the blue first. I'm gonna make the distance mountain first. So I'm gonna use the blue, the black, and white. More black. Lighter. So I'm going to assume that this is also a distant mountain. Okay, so here I'm gonna add some darker distant mountain here. Make sure to always apply the rules of perspective, guys. The farther it become lighter, or it will become more bluish in color. Okay. So maybe it's okay if we don't add then another coat, or the detail, or the second coat. And I'm gonna make this part really light, so I'm gonna use the light green, because this is really near a nearer mountain or mountainside. I'm gonna use the yellow to burn sienna, and a little blue and white. Okay, I'm gonna add a little blush. Okay, then I'm going to add I'm gonna make this one darker, so I'll use the blue, the black, and a little burnt sienna. I think that's dark, so I'm gonna add a little white. More white. Okay. So on this one, I'm gonna make it darker. So again, blue. And more black and burnt sienna, and white, little white. So these are just the base color, guys, for the first coat, because the paint is really thin, so again I need to add a little more coatings or more layers of paint. Add another layer, and this one I'm going to make it darker. Oh, that's really blue. It's not nice. So I'm gonna add some burnt sienna. I think I'm gonna extend more. here. So I'm gonna add this, so I'm gonna make it dark black and burnt sienna. Little blue and burnt sienna. I'm going to extend it until here.
Guys, if you like my tutorial, please hit like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. If you want to see my paintings, you can visit my website www.jmlesondra.com.
If it feels like drying, guys, just add a little water on the tip of your brush. Okay. Not more burnt sienna and blue. Okay. I think that's dark enough. So I'm gonna add the water. I'm gonna make it bluish, blue green. So I'm gonna use the yellow and the blue, more blue, and a little black to make it darker. Another blue and green, a brown or yellow, dark.
If you are still a newbie, guys, so if you are starting, you just started to paint, please keep on practicing, keep experimenting on the materials, and in time you will learn the proper executions.
This is just the first cut, guys, or the base color, so we can add more later. Make it lighter. Okay, just going to spread the paint. Okay, to add more. Okay. Okay. I think that's we're done with the first coat of our water of the, or the river. So I think I'm gonna start with the second coat. Or the details. So I'm gonna make this the distant mountain, the nearest mountain first. So I'm gonna use this brush, 1 inch, Number 4, flat brush. Gonna make it wet. And I'm gonna start adding the details. So I'm gonna add queen. I'm planning to put some pliff here, so I'm gonna use the white. And a little yellow. Or the burn sienna. Gonna add more yellow. Add some burn sienna.
Just follow what I'm doing, guys.
Okay. Skin the brush. I think I'm gonna make zoom it a little closer. Okay. Okay, I think that's a good idea.
I'm going to add some trees in this part, and it should be bluish in color.
So I'm gonna use the blue. With a little black and white. That's dark, so lighter. Okay. Okay. So here, I'm gonna put here. I think I'm gonna make it darker. More black. More light.
This part's gonna be really tricky, so we should control the values of the color, like how dark or how light it is. So it should be darker than the background mountains and lighter than the near mountains or near bluish color.
Okay. So here. Okay. I'm gonna add more. So I think I'm gonna start adding the. I think I'm gonna make this one lighter. I think I'm gonna start adding the highlights to the forest. The blue is green and white. Okay.
a little advice, guys.
So if you're going to make some distant forest, make sure the difference of the color. So if the forest is from far from us, make the color more color. So add a blue or
a little black on it,
just like I'm doing here. So you observe that
the green becomes color because I add a little blue on it and also a little white. So that's how you make it more smoother or lighter. So just observe the values of your color, guys. How dark or how light it is.
So why am I gonna make the field lighter? Okay. I'm going to add some brown color of the fields. So I'm gonna use the burnt sienna and a little yellow, and white.
Make also the brown color softer or not so sharp. So it should be lighter. You should be careful on watching the values of the color, guys. Especially when it has a distance or it's far from you.
Okay. I think we did a good job for that.
Add a little more details.
Okay. I think we have a... I think that's good. So, can I make this one? So I'm gonna focus the camera on that area. And gonna start this one. So this is a cliff here. So I'm gonna make the gray color. So I'm still using the color here on my palette. So blue and black. With some white. And burnt sienna. So this part will be... We don't see any light in this part. I'm gonna put any light. I'm not going to put any light. So this part will be dark. Okay. So, the cliff. Okay. Lighter. So I'm using the still grayish color, guys, with some little burnt sienna. So you can mix the blue. I'm going to add some highlights on the upper area of this mountain. So I'm gonna use the yellow, the blue, a little red, and white, and a little blue. And white. I'm gonna make it light. So I'm using the number 6 flat brush. So I think I'm gonna add some dark part on this mountain, on this cliff. So I'm gonna blue and black and white. This will just emphasize the cliff.
Again guys, if you like my tutorial, please hit like, comment, add some comment, or you can suggest, and subscribe to my channel. Also please visit my website if you wanna see my other works, my paintings, my older works. That will help me a lot.
Okay. I'm gonna need to add more white, light color for the highlights. Okay. Gonna need to add more dark here. So I'm gonna use the blue, the black, and white. Gonna make it more green, so I'm gonna use the green. Just mix it to the gray. Lighter green. Create some red. I'm gonna add a little on the cliff. Okay, so I'm gonna add the highlights. So just add white. Gonna need some yellowish highlights. Okay. Next, I'm going to add the highlights on this cliff. So I'm gonna make it more really light. So this will be my the center of the view. So I'm gonna use the white and burn sienna. And yellow. and to emphasize this part. So I am using the same brush, the number 6 flat brush. Okay. I'm going to mix some burnt sienna and yellow and white. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna make it more lighter. So I'm gonna use yellow and white. I'm gonna add white, pure white.
This will emphasize the cliff even more.
Okay, just follow what I'm doing, guys. I'm gonna make this a really rocky cliff. And always remember, guys, not to overdo, not to put everything. Just leave some little spaces. Okay.
It's important to emphasize the gaps between the rocks.
More white. More white. Okay. Going to add some bluish effect here, or brownish effect. So I'm gonna use the burnt sienna and the yellow. Just a little yellow. Okay guys, so next I'm going to add the trees here. So I'm going to mix the blue and green and red. Blue, little white and yellow. More yellow. Okay. I'm still using the same brush, the number 6 flat brush. So I'm gonna add it here. Okay, and then I'm gonna put the highlights. So I'm gonna use the yellow and white. Okay, I'm not gonna add the yellow kind trees in the entire area, so I think I'm gonna mix it with some red tree and then sort of. Okay, so I'm gonna add some other types of tree, like orange color tree or flowering tree. So I'm gonna use the yellow and the red. Okay, that will add some drama on our painting. I make this orange or the orange tree. This one also. Okay, that's a nice tree for this part, and I'm gonna make the highlights yellow with some white. So I'm still using the same kind of brush, guys. So remember always to practice using your brush. Okay, so this is just how you do it. And remember guys, not to overdo. Very nice tree. Gonna add little here. And this part. Okay, so we have now the cliff. Okay, next, so I'm going to put details on this nearer cliff. So I think when I use gray, so I'm thinking that this should be dark, no light is coming in this part. Okay, that might be a good idea. I'm going to use the blue and the brown. The magenta, the blue, and a little white. Just have to make some, what do you call this, some stones. Okay, then we're gonna make highlights white, just add white in the color. So this is not the highlight, guys. This is it's natural color. highlight should be lighter than this color. So guys, if you like my tutorial, please like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you want to see my paintings or other works, you can visit my website www.jeremylisondra.com. To all my past works and you can see it there. Okay, I think that's a really nice cliff. Okay, I prefer that clip not to be light, so that's enough. I think I'm gonna add a little light in this area later, so some light to strike on the on this part. Okay, so I'm gonna need to add the trees on the top of that cliff. So again, I'm gonna use the blue and the yellow and the red. More blue. More yellow. Okay. I'm gonna make this area darker, so I think I'm gonna add some emphasis on our cliff. Okay. Okay. And I'm gonna add the highlights. So I think I'm gonna use the same color, this one. So white and yellow and burnt sienna.
I'm going to add some highlights on the trees.
So I'm going to use the yellow, the blue, white, and little red. Okay. I'm going to add another color, like bluish. Little yellow. and some orange trees. So you can see some many varieties of trees in this painting. So I'm gonna make more highlights. Okay, I think that's enough. And lastly, I'm going to add some details on this cliff. So first, I'm going to zoom out the entire view. To see the entire painting. Okay. Okay, still using the same brush, the number 6 flat brush. Gonna use the blue, the burnt sienna, and white. So I'm gonna add some cave here. So I'm gonna put add some stalactites. More brown. And yellow. Lighter.
Remember guys to add some gaps between the rocks, so that's also important thing to do, and it should be dark.
Okay. Some bluish tone. Okay, guys, again, if you like my tutorial, please comment, like, subscribe, and visit my website if you wanna see my paintings. Okay. add more on white. Okay. To the dots and add some light in this one. Okay. We are almost done. I think I'm gonna add more here. Just follow what I'm doing, guys. Now I execute the brush. So you observe in my painting that you can really see the strokes of the brush. That's okay. Another brown, black, and orange now. Don't put it here to emphasize. Okay. Gonna emphasize the stones. So I'm adding the dark color on the gaps, between the gaps. So I'm using the lighter burnt sienna here with black. Then I'm gonna use the dark red burnt sienna. Okay. Okay, I think that's really good. Gonna make this part really dark because it's a cave. So, but I'm not using plain black. So I'm using the black and burnt sienna and a little blue. Okay. So it's a cave, guys, so it should be dark. It's supposed to be dark. Okay, so I'm going to add the trees. So I'm going to use the same brush, the flat number 6 brush. I'm going to use the black, the yellow, the red. You can actually use a bigger flat brush on this or the fan brush. It's still up to you. As long as you are comfortable. So it's really important, guys, to practice using your brush. Okay, so I'm gonna need to add a little highlights, but not so light. I'm going to add a little white and a little yellow. A small amount of yellow and white. Okay, I think that's good. So I think we're almost done. And I'm going to retouch some areas. I think I'm gonna add some highlights in this part that will add some drama on the painting. So the same color with this. So I'm gonna use the white and yellow on a little barnsena. More white. So the same brush, guys. The one number six flat brush. So just follow what I'm doing. Just observe how I execute to perform or to create this kind of effect. Okay, so that's good. That's enough. I'm gonna add some highlights on the trees. So I'm gonna use the same green and white. Okay, that's cool. Okay, so I am now adding the water reflections. So this will create a more realistic effect. So I'm going to zoom in to see it clearly. Okay. Okay. I'm going to use the number 4 flat brush for this one. So, in reflection, in creating the reflection, guys, make sure to just follow everything on the above like a mirror. So if this is white, so I'm gonna add the white here, so just create the reflection. I'm going to add some white disturbance here using the almost plain white with a little blue. This will occur if it has a strong wind on this area, so you can visibly see it. Okay. Okay. And then I'm going to copy this for a reflection. So I'm gonna use the white and a little yellow. just small horizontal lines and doing this, guys. It will create the effect. Okay, that's enough. I'm gonna do this one also. So I'm gonna use the same color, but I think lighter. So I'm gonna use the white. I'm gonna add a little white. Then do it. Okay. Just more quick horizontal lines. I'm doing this, guys. Just follow what I'm doing. This one also. Okay. Okay. I think it's almost done, guys. It's really realistic, so I'm going to add more light on the highlights, on the reflection. So I'm going to make it lighter.
Remember, guys, that you are always the judge of your painting. So observe it, and if it's okay to you, then that's fine.
Okay, it's very nice, and I think I'm gonna make this a gorgeous part. Gorgeous, so I'm gonna mix the blue and the black and white, more white. I think you guys to move here. Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna copy this area here. So maybe we're just going to put the bluish or the grayish of the, or copy the farther mountains. So I think I'm gonna use the same color but darker with some blue. Okay, some green. Make it lighter. Okay, I think we're already almost done this part also. So I think we're gonna copy the gray stones. So the same thing, blue and white and black. That's the white, the lighter. Okay. And I'm going to finish the cave. I'm gonna add some details. So I'm gonna use the black and blue version. Okay, can add more highlights. Where are details? Okay. And lastly, I'm going to add some dark gray tone on the water. So I'm still using the same brush, the number 6 flat brush. I use the blue, the yellow, and the red. Guys, you observe that I am always using red on green. So this will make the color more matured. So you can see. You can observe the green is pale, and as I said, it's more matured. Okay. Add it here. I think I'm gonna make it more bluish. Okay. And also this course, this part also. I'm gonna make the blue screen lighter. Or the blue green. Just observe what I'm doing, guys. You see that I'm creating some horizontal quick strokes. So this is how I create the water. Can add some little reflection. This part. So I'm using gray, guys, the same color as this one. Okay. Okay. Also this part. I'm doing some retouch, guys. I think that's enough, guys. It's okay to me. So add more.
I think I am done with this painting lesson.
So again, I'm gonna say thank you so much for following my tutorial, for following this video. And if you like this video, please click like, subscribe to my channel, and add some comments. Or visit my website www.jmlistener.com if you wanna see my or more of my paintings. And thank you so much, guys. All I wanna say to you guys is keep on practicing, keep on experimenting, and don't be afraid to paint or to apply what you think or what you observe. So that's how you will improve. So again, guys, thank you so much.
Until next time.